blessed day, my beloved brethren. Wherever you are right now, my prayer is, may the grace, love, and hope of God be with you all. I am Brother Jet, your co-worker in the faith, and I'm so grateful to God and very excited to share to you our Bible devotion today. We can find our encouragement in the book of Acts, chapter 15, verses 36 to 41. And after some days, Paul said to Barnabas, "Let us return and visit the brothers in every city where we proclaim the word of the Lord and see how they are." Now Barnabas wanted to take with them John called Mark, but Paul thought best not to take with them one who had withdrawn from them in Pamphylia and had not gone with them to the work. And there arose a sharp disagreement, so that they separated from each other. Barnabas took Mark with him and sailed away to Cyprus. But Paul chose Silas and departed, having been commended by the brothers to the grace of the Lord. And he went through Syria and Cilicia, strengthening the churches. Have you noticed the Bible gave us a very good example that not just ordinary men quarrels and disagree, but even how godly, how holy, and how sanctified someone is, we are susceptible to divisions and disagreements because of sin. We are susceptible to its infection, and one of the main objectives of sin is division. That is what sin ultimately sets out to do, is to divide. Sin divides us from God, and it divides us from each other. If God's example is just an ordinary people, we might ignore and don't invest time to learn in this story. That is the point of this story. God highlighted the sharp disagreement, telling us that even the closest and deepest kind of relationship, there is still a possibility of disunity and separation, telling us that we can never be complacent to ourselves, to anybody, but only to the grace and mercy of God. This sequence of passages just showed how men and women are weak, that at any time, at any moment, at any scenario, we are inconsistent. Remember, they just celebrated of their unity. They rejoice over conflicts, and now again, they are facing conflicts. Not just conflict, but a heated debate, a heated contention. And it made even worse because the guys who preached to be united and to be still when disunity comes are the guys who disagreed. For just few days only, as the text says, and it seems they already forgot the principle of loving, patience, unity, and care for one another. And it is even more unfortunate, sadder, because they've been friends, started in Acts chapter 9 and traveling together since Acts chapter 11 up to this point. They have been ministry partners for several years. They've faced death together. They've traveled with each other. They've slept by each other's side. They've experienced so much of life together. And yet, misunderstanding happened. And the worst was they parted ways. But here's the hope that we have in this passage. If you mess up in the ministry or in life, don't ever feel like you can't get back in the game. Sometimes God works in people for years with many faults along the way before they are ready for ministry. Be patient to everyone. It's never too late to reconnect with someone you've let down. We've all failed someone in our past. It's never too late to forgive someone who let you down, just as we've all failed someone else. We've also had someone fail us. Sometimes people go years without speaking because of a falling out. Someone hurts us and we assume they will always be that type of person, unchanging. But we need to always remember that if God can change us over time, so God can do to someone else. Reach out to them. They just might surprise you. God bless you all.